Katu in Thailand. A British holidaymaker is about to make a bungee jump from a platform 165 feet above a lake.
I don't think you meant to look down on these kind of things.
It was something that I had always wanted to do.
He takes a breath and plunges towards the water at 80 miles an hour.
I was expecting to just whiz it back up.
Instead, it's an empty harness that bounces back. Cambridge engineering student Rishi Baveja worked hard to get a degree, and after graduating, he decided to celebrate by going travelling. He said goodbye to his parents in Bradford and headed off to Thailand to join a group of friends.
I was figuring out everything that I wanted to do in life, everything I wanted to see, and every opportunity I wanted to grasp. And a few of my friends were actually already out there, and they said, you know, you should come. I said, right, I'm coming, and I just booked it and took a flight out and met them. I thought, you know, why not? You only live once, right?
The pals are determined to have fun. And like many young men, adrenaline challenges are on the agenda.
I had a long list of things that I wanted to just kind of tick off my life list. Zip lining through the rainforest, seeing all the wildlife while kind of being so high up in the treetops, it was incredible.
That was just one early highlight of a hugely successful holiday. Rishi's having such a great time, he doesn't want to go home. When his friends head back to the UK, he decides to stay another week.
I just thought, you know, I can live in Thailand for another week and have another amazing week of this, so why not?
And it's this experience that captures his imagination. It's in Katu on the island of Phuket, a popular bungee jump set in the most spectacular jungle setting.
It had a 100% safety record, looked like it was a cool place to do the jump. It just looked perfect for me at the time.
But just before he goes ahead, he decides to call his mum just to tell her what he's planning to do.
From the start of that phone call, my mum didn't want me to do it. I guess it was a mixture of me trying to convince her with a safety record and ultimately, you know, me being me and just saying, well, you know, I'm an adult now, I need to make these choices and, you know, I'm gonna do it no matter what.
At the jump site, Rishi is excited, particularly by the beautiful location. A crane lifts the jump platform to a height of 165 feet above the lake. His souvenir video shows Rishi trying to control his nerves. And who could blame him?
You get higher, you're like, okay, I'm quite high. And then you realize that it's still not stopping and it keeps going higher and higher. And you start to get more worried and more worried because you know that you're going to have to come down and it's not going to be on the platform. And I tried not to really think about it. I just went with the flow.
At the top, the realization of what he's about to do hits home.
My feet froze and my heart was pounding. I could just remember it's just like bang, bang. I could just hear it. I couldn't hear anything else. I couldn't hear anyone. It was just silent.
A member of staff has strapped his feet together with a harness and attached the bungee cord to it. Rishi is getting more nervous by the second.
Every inch of me said, don't do this. Like, this is the stupidest thing you've ever done. Why are you going to do this? But at the same time, my body was also tingling with adrenaline. I was just excited. I was like, wow, I can't believe I'm actually going to do this.
This is what he came here for, and he's not backing out now. In less than a minute, he'll wish he had.
I was like, you just need to man up. I know you're scared. Do it. And once you've done it, you'll love it.
It's time. He inches towards the edge of the platform.
I don't think you meant to look down on these kind of things.
He takes one last deep breath, crosses himself for luck, and jumps.
Adrenaline goes through every part of your body, and it feels a lot slower than it is. Everything stops, your mind is just clear, there's nothing to think about. Very lost in that moment of free fall.
But he expects it to stop within seconds.
I didn't realise anything had gone wrong. I was expecting to just whiz it back up.
But he doesn't. The harness around his feet comes clean off, and he crashes straight into the water, travelling at 80 miles an hour. The video of the jump records his yelp of fear just before he hits the water. On the platform, the instructor gasps as he realizes what's happened. Below, Rishi is in the water, shocked, but alive.
The only thing that I could think about was, get out of the water right now, you shouldn't be here.
But Rishi is injured. No one realizes how badly, including him. But somehow, he manages to swim ashore.
The chap that was meant to jump after me pulled me out. I didn't understand why everyone was making a fuss. I just wanted to lie down for 2 minutes and get my breath back. Like, have you got insurance? And I managed to give them my mum's phone number. And after that, I passed out.
Rishi is taken to hospital. He's taken the full impact of the fall on his chest and suffered extensive injuries, among them a ruptured spleen, torn liver and kidneys, and collapsed lungs. It's so serious, he's on a breathing machine for a month.
And as soon as I woke up and I realized that I wasn't breathing by myself and I had about 5 or 6 different tubes coming out of my body, I was just like, this is no joke. I got hit with a real dose of reality.
In fact, his recovery takes a full year, but doctors told him how much worse it could have been.
They said that, you know, if with that pressure, you know, and that force, you know, you saw what happened to your organs. If you'd hit that head first, it's extremely likely that you would have had brain damage or something worse. So, in fact, hitting it chest first was, in some ways, quite lucky.
Coming up at Westcliff on Sea, paramedics arrive at a flat to find 19-year-old Keegan's heart is showing no signs of life.
He's still not breathing.
Are they there?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to leave you with them. Okay, well done. You've done really well.
Grittenham, near Royal Wooton Bassett in Wiltshire. At the motocross track, 40 competitors line up for a championship race. The starting grid drops and they thunder across the rough terrain. Harry, one of the youngest riders, moves into second place as he films from a camera mounted on his quad bike.
I had a lot of pressure because I was winning the championship. I'd won the last round and I needed to do well.
He's a top rider, but at the second jump, disaster. He crashes and is thrown to the ground. He's hit by a vehicle close behind. But there are 37 more to come. Harry wheels.